Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh.
All the fields we go, laughing all the way.
Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright.
What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
From Hollywood, the Lawrence Welk Network presents the annual Lawrence Welk Christmas Show.
Thank you, my friends. Thank you very kindly. Christmas greetings. Yes, it's that wonderful time of the year again. And this is the show you and I look forward to every year. As always on our Christmas show, we have a stage full of children of our musical family. And we'll meet all of them a little later in the show. Let's start the program with our wonderful husband and wife team, Guy and Ralna.
Sweet little Jesus boy, they made you be born in a manger. Sweet little holy child, and we didn't know who you were. We didn't know you'd come to
to take our sins away. Our eyes were blind, we could not see. We didn't know who you were. You have shown us how we treated you, but please, sir, forgive us, Lord. We didn't know it was you. Sweet little Jesus boy, born long time ago. Sweet little holy child, and we didn't know who
wrong. Here's a young man who's always a hit at our Christmas party. Ladies and gentlemen, Arthur Duncan.
Arthur Duncan, one of the really great tap dancers. How'd you like his exit? Marching right back into the barracks until next Christmas. Thanks, Arthur. Great as always. Joe Feeney takes the spotlight now with one of the loveliest Christmas songs ever written, O Holy Night. You will hear Bob Smale at the piano and Myron Floren at the organ. Myron Floren? Well, let's see.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul found its worth. A thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. On your knees, oh, hear the angel voices, oh, no. Was born.
Isn't that beautiful? When Joe gets a song like that one, he really soars. And that really was Myron Floren at the organ. Once a keyboard genius, always a keyboard genius, I guess. It's about time to let you people out there dance now, and the band is ready with a champagne arrangement of the old standby, Santa Claus is Coming to Town. Oh, and by the way, there's a new dance team making its first appearance toward the end of this number. It's a short dance, so watch closely. Wasn't that cute? Weren't they adorable? Did you notice Lawrence trying to get the little boy to take a bow? Well, that little fella is Lawrence's grandson, Lawrence Welk III, and his partner is Jenny Griffiths, daughter of Sandy Griffiths, and her husband, Brent. Little Lawrence and Jenny were born just 2 weeks apart in the same year. Of course, like all kids, they went and grew up, and here they are today. They didn't turn out to be another Bobby and Cissy, but they're still pretty cute, aren't they? Oh, my, time do fly. Well, back to reality, sort of. Next up is me, and I've got six of the pretty Welk girls with me, and we're going to sing a Christmas standard. I'm sure you'll all know this one. Silver bell.
Silver bell.
Silver bell.
Silver bell.
It's Christmas time in the city. Ring-a-ling.
Ring-a-ling.
Hear them ring. Sidewalks, busy sidewalks, dressed in holiday style. In the air, there's a feeling of Christmas. Children laughing, people passing, meeting smile after smile. And on every street corner, you hear silver bell.
The chorus, Santa Claus.
Silver bell.
He's busy now because
it's Christmas time
in the city.
Ring-a-ling.
It fills the winter air.
Hear them ring.
You hear it everywhere.
Soon it will be Christmas. You think I looked just a wee bit younger there? And my hair was a little curlier and a little darker? You did? Oh, well. You know, one of the great attractions of our annual Christmas show was always the children. All of us in the band brought our kids under the age of 13 to the show. Well, as time went along, some of us began bringing our grandkids. Here's Lawrence to introduce two of his.
We've had so many nice comments about Tanya and Anacani singing together. So this evening, they have some extra help. Two of my grandchildren, Kevin Philp and Lawrence Welk III.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Great.
He's making a list and checking it twice. He's gonna find out if you're naughty or nice.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Oh.
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake.
Oh.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good, so be good for goodness sake.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better.
I'm telling you why.
Santa Claus is coming. Santa Claus is coming. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Oh.
Well, they got through it all right. And kids, don't go away. Santa really is coming.
Well, I don't know what it was that was holding Kevin's attention, but something sure had him mesmerized. He didn't blink for 3 minutes. Of course, That's the fun of doing this show with your kids. I know, I went through it a few times, and it always scared me to death. Of course, both the Welk boys are grown up now. Buns, that's Lawrence Welk III's nickname, is now a helicopter pilot working in the news media in Los Angeles. And Kevin is just about ready to graduate from Loyola University in Los Angeles. And both boys are engaged to be married. Ah, yes, time do fly. You know, it never ceases to amaze me that we had so many different kinds of talent in our band. Here's a sound you don't hear too often in a dance band. A lovely lady playing a beautiful cello solo. Here's Charlotte and her cello with the Victor Herbert classic, Toyland. She does have a beautiful tone, doesn't she? Thank you, Charlotte. That was lovely. Ken Delo sings a novelty song from the movie Scrooge, which was based on Charles Dickens' famous novel, A Christmas Carol. Ken, Bobby, Cissy, and all the gang get together for December the 25th.
Here's a song you can all join in, singing and dancing and having a little fun. All right, here we go. Of all the days and all the years that I'm familiar with, there's only one that's really fun, December the 25th. Ask anyone named Robinson or Brown or Jones or Smith their favorite day, and they will say
December the 25th.
Correct!
December the 25th, it is December the 25th, the dearest day in all the year, December the 25th.
If there's a day in history that's more than any myth, beyond a doubt, one day stands out,
December the 25th.
Correct!
December the 25th, it is December the 25th, the dearest day in all the year, December the 25th.
December the 25th.
I know that song was from Dickens' Christmas Carol, but it sure did sound Irish to me. All of us in the musical family were delighted when Larry Hooper recovered from a long illness and was able to return to the show. Here's Lawrence to welcome him back.
It was just 4 years ago when Larry Hooper went on the sick list. A serious illness that had all of us worried for a long time. It's such a blessing and joy to have Larry back. It certainly helps to make it a Merry Christmas. Here's Larry with a song the kiddies always enjoy.
High on the housetop, reindeer paws, out jumps jolly Santa Claus. Lift out a great big bag of toys, all for the good little girls and boys. Ho, 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 I wanna go. Ho, 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 I wanna go. High on the housetop, quick, quick, quick. Slide down the chimney with good Saint Nick. I'd say to Santa, howdy do. Do you need someone helping you? Gee, it would be a lot of fun, filling up stockings one by one. Ho, 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 I wanna go. Ho, 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 I wanna go. High on the housetop, quick, quick, quick. Slide down the chimney with good Saint Nick. For you could even wink an eye, we'd have presents piled up high. How it surprised my family, my friend Santa Claus and me. Ho, 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 I wanna go. Ho, 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 I wanna go. High on the housetop, quick, quick, quick. Slide down the chimney with good Saint Nick. And slide down the chimney with good Saint Nick.
I think Hoopy was having a little problem with his props there. Couldn't quite get that big destroyer to work. Must have been one of those batteries not included toys. Well, that's okay. Larry would rather play with one of his model trains anyway. The Bells of St. Mary's was a popular movie with Bing Crosby and Ingrid Bergman, remember? But before that, it was a wonderful song, and it still is. And here's the band with George Cates conducting. Jack Emmel's going to ring the bells. And there's some new guy in the organ. I wonder what happened to Myron. I guess when Myron noticed that Lawrence was at the organ, he decided he'd better go back to the accordion. What is it with these accordion players? Let them sing two lines in Jingle Bells, and they want to do everything. Well, it was so great working with Myron on the tribute to Lawrence. One of my favorite moments on that show was Myron leading the big band medley. You know, Christmas wouldn't be Christmas without carols. Here's our choir with a selection of some of the best loved. Join in if you feel like it. I'm sure you've all known some of these since your childhood. Here's the choir.
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies.
Reminds me of the unexpected snowstorm we had at our home in Tennessee last winter. In less than 8 hours, we had 22 inches of snow piled up on our decks. And there we were, no film, and we were snowed in for 4 days. And for us, they called it the storm of the century. Very exciting, especially after living in California for so long. And if you're asking, snow in Tennessee? Yes, Tennessee. My partner, Ava Barber, and I have a Rainbow Jamboree Theater down there in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee. We entertain every night except Sunday, from May through November, with songs and comedy and great country music. Well, all kinds of music. So if you're ever down Great Smoky's way, come see us. We'd love to see you. Tom Netherton, our towering baritone from Minnesota, had just joined the musical family when we taped this show. Here's Lawrence to introduce him.
Recently, I was back in North Dakota for a family reunion, and I heard a wonderful young singer. I was so impressed, I invited him to come on our show, and I'm sure you folks will like him, too. His name is Tom Netherton, and he comes from Bloomington, Minnesota. Tom got off to a very good start with me. He asked me to play the organ for him. How do you like that?
Holy night, all
heavenly hosts sing Alleluia. Christ the Savior is born. Christ the Savior is born.
Great voice. I thought he did a great job, especially considering that this was his first show. And he had to be nervous with his boss playing accompaniment. Lawrence is really busy in the show, isn't he? Singing, leading the band, playing the organ. You don't suppose he's going to be Santa Claus, too? Nah. Myron Floren livens the party with no, not a polka, but a lively rendition of a traditional holiday favorite, the Christmas song.
Me to get you an extra Christmas check this year. Now let's hear from Jimmy Roberts, and it sounds like Jimmy has a new color scheme for Christmas.
I'll have a blue Christmas without you. I'll be so blue thinking about you. Decorations of red on a green Christmas tree won't mean a thing if you're not here with me. I'll have a blue, blue Christmas, that's certain. And when that blue heartache starts hurting, you'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white. But I'll have a blue, blue Christmas. You'll be doing all right with your Christmas of white. But I'll have a blue, blue Christmas.
I don't think Jim will have a blue Christmas. He's got a loving wife and a family who all think he is wonderful. And they're going to make sure his Christmas is happy. Well, now we come to the part of the show which always made the Welk Christmas program the highest rated show of the year. Year after year, the kids and Santa Claus. And let me tell you, I personally know a lot about Santa. Anyway, here's Lawrence to start things off.
You know, folks, I'm a very lucky man. I have two wonderful families, my musical family and my own personal family. And it's always a very nice feeling when I can bring them together. On this annual Christmas show, they're all here this evening, and I think I'll just let them introduce themselves. Myron?
And friends, over the last 20 years, I've had the pleasure of introducing from one to five daughters, but of course, children all grow up. And we're turning the tradition over to the younger members of the band. And here's our first one, our piano man, Bob Smale.
Thank you very much, Myron. Merry Christmas, everybody. This is my wife, Mary, and I think I'll let my daughter introduce herself and her brother.
My name is Margaret Smale, and this is my brother, Robbie. And we'd like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
May I just interfere long enough to say that I, through the grapevine, I heard that you had a lot of talent in your family. And perhaps you would play something for us? You did so nice last year. Would you? Okay. Let Daddy come over and help, please. Let me shake hands with you. Congratulations. And look over here, ladies and gentlemen. I can't help but thinking of the time I called this young man, and he was too young to put him to work. He was only 15 years of age, and now he has a practically grown family. Buddy, would you please take over?
I sure will. Thank you, Lawrence. I'm Buddy Merrill. This is my wife, Ruth. And this is our number two daughter, Melody. You want to say something?
Hi, my name is Melody, and I've got a sister that's 13 years old, and she's home.
Very good.
Thanks.
Thank you, Buddy. My name is Henry Cresta, and we are going to let our oldest daughter do the introductions.
Thank you, Daddy. First, I would like to introduce my mother. And this is my sister, Lucinda. She is 7. My brother, Henry, he's 3. And my name is Marion, and I am 11 years old, and I'd like to wish all our friends and relatives in Toronto, Canada, a very Merry Christmas.
Hello, my name is Danny Dale, and I'd like to introduce my mother, Marguerite, my sister, Dee Dee, and my younger brother, David.
Thank you, Danny. I'm Mickey McMahon. And this is my youngest son, Patrick, and we'd both like to wish you all a very Merry Christmas.
Hey. I'm Dave Edwards. This is my wife, Phyllis. Our younger boy, Charlie, he's 2.5. And our older boy, David, he's 5.
Hi, I'm Ken Delo. This is our son, Kevin Patrick. He's 19 months, and he's shy. And this is my wife, Marilyn.
And this is our daughter, Kimberly Ann, just turned 5. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you, Kimberly. My name is Donna Mayer, and I'd like to introduce to you my husband, Jim, and my oldest boy, Jimmy, and he's 12 years old, and my daughter here, Christine, and she's 4.5 years old, and little David, he's 3.25, and two of our family members weren't invited, and our little boy will tell you about them. David, will you tell us the name of the puppy dog?
Right in there.
Yes, right in there.
Isn't there a person in there?
No, there's no person in there. What's the name of our dog?
Blackie.
And tell me something. What does Flaggy like to eat?
Dog food.
Yes, but doesn't he also like chocolate?
Huh? Yeah.
You like chocolate, do you? You didn't tell him that you were my daughter.
Oh, I'm proud of it, too, folks.
Well, just because you wouldn't tell me, I'll let the other daughter speak.
Hi, I'm Shirley. This is my son, David.
Merry Christmas.
David is just 13, and this is Lisa, who is 6.
Hi.
My husband, Bob, is home with our sports casualty, Jonathan, who's 11, along with Laura and Rob, our older children. We all wish you a very Merry Christmas.
I'm Tanya, and this is my youngest, Kevin. He's 2. He was just 2. And this is my little boy, Larry. Do you want to say Merry Christmas?
Yeah. Merry Christmas.
There. And this is our new daughter addition to our family, Carmen. She's 12 and she's from Mexico.
Hi.
I'm friend Welk, and I want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas. And I feel proud that I can hold Lawrence Welk the 3rd.
Thank you, Mrs. Welk. I'm John Liddell. I'm almost 11, and this is my dad, Barney.
Hi, I'm Maroon Holt, and this is my first year with Lawrence, and I'm very happy to be here. This is my wife, Claudine, my boy, Tim, he's 9 and a half, and Heidi, she's 8.
Hi, my name's Frank Griffiths. This is my wife, Sandy, and the little baby you've heard crying is the one here that all of a sudden got hungry. It's Amy, and she's, she was born in April. This is our oldest daughter, Jenny, and she's 3 and a half years old.
Come over here. Don't look so sad. Let's put a little life in this party. How about you singing a song for us? Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Frosty the snowman was a jolly happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a tinness and a wise man and a Frosty Snowman was very good at sleep. He was made of snow, but the children know how he came to life one day.
Well, I'm sure you recognize that this is going to be my next champagne lady.
Thank you, Lawrence. My name is Don Staples, and this is my lovely wife, Betty. And these are my 2 daughters right here. This is little Debbie here. She's 3 and a half. And this is Cheryl, 5. And Cheryl, would you like to say something to the audience?
Merry Christmas.
Very good.
And now, kids, our very special guest, and I wonder if you can guess who it is. Merry Christmas, Andy.
Pleasure to be back for your Christmas party.
Have we ever been waiting for you?
Well, have you boys and girls been good boys and girls all year?
Yeah!
Let's get to the present. Bobby Frederick. Ooh. David Edwards. Merry Christmas. Bobby Smith. Merry Christmas, Bobby. Cheryl Staples. Merry Christmas. Kevin Delo.
Back here.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. John Liddell. Merry Christmas, John. David Kevin. Marcus Smith. David Dale. Merry Christmas, David. Jonathan Prince.
The Fredericks are all over the place. It's a big one. We got two bags here. David. I got help for that. Danny Dale. Deborah State. Burrow. Maybe Mary Christmas.
Easy there.
Henry Christmas. Easy.
That's enough.
Easy there. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
That could be on my way.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Well, how'd you like that?
I certainly hope you did, because it was hot in that suit and the beard and the wig. Man, I'm not sure I fooled everybody. I think it was Dave Edwards' boy who came in the day we taped and asked one of the other kids, who's wearing the suit today, Dick Dale? And I vividly remember one show when Buddy Merrill's little daughter, Melody, kept saying hi, Santa, to me very sweetly every time I passed her when I was handing out the gifts. As it happened, her gift was the last. And by that time, she was absolutely furious and screamed, hey, Santa, don't I get a present? And then, of course, there are my own kids, Rick, Dee Dee, David, and Danny. Everyone always asks if they knew I was Santa. Well, I would suppose they did, because I was never there when everybody was being introduced. But I guess they were smart enough not to say anything. Kids are fantastic. Love them all. Well, there you are. Time goes on, but Christmas is always with us. And it really is one of the best times of the year. Lawrence said something at the end of this show that was especially meaningful.
Our society, our nation, and the world all need our help. Let us hope this holy...